Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the magic wand tool to quickly digitize a shape from a picture. Now, this is going to work better in some cases than in others, but your best bet is to find the simplest image possible if you're using the magic wand tool. I just Googled up a picture of an apple, and this is obviously someone else's artwork, so I'm just using this for demonstration purposes, but it's a good example because it's just a nice, clean image. If I want to bring this into StitchArtist, I can right-click on it and copy the image, and then go to Embrilliance StitchArtist and paste it in there. So I actually have two copies there because I've done this now twice, so I'll delete one. I can't see my image because I have the preview turned off, so let's turn it on. And I'm gonna use my magic wand tool, and let's say we wanna create this, turn this into an object right here. So I'm just gonna click in this area, and Embrilliance created a bunch of different control points on there to create that shape. It didn't overdo it. If you have a very, the results here are pretty decent, and we can actually have it create this shape and this shape too. But you can see that there's a whole bunch of extra control points down there and there, and we don't need actually all those control points. Fortunately, we can clean it up a bit. So I'm just gonna select this particular object right here, and actually, I want to do a little bit of editing of my control points. So I am going to click on them, and I can see where each one of these control points are. Now, like I said, there's too many, and once you get experience with digitizing and you understand how these control points are affecting the shape, you realize that you could probably get away with taking some of these out here, and your shape is not going to change really at all whatsoever. So I'm just going to kind of remove some of these, and of course I can hit Command Z or undo if removing one of the control points is going to radically affect the shape. You can also adjust these handles too, and you know, using your control points and handles, you can change the shape as well. Why am I removing these extra points? Well, the extra complexity is going to create more needle points, like more stitches in a certain area. So you really want to keep your shapes as streamlined as possible. Now, as you see now, I really changed the shape here. That was not a good idea, but I can get that curve back by just clicking on my anchor point and dragging out the handle there. And now I have a couple of, I don't want to do that, Command Z. That's an anchor point and a handle. Now, after I go through all the trouble of removing all of these anchor points here, it might have just been worth it for me to use my Bezier drawing tools and to just draw this shape myself. So the magic wand tool is really great, but sometimes it creates more problems than what it's worth. But it is a great tool to have at your disposal when you're learning to digitize, and sometimes it can save you a bunch of work. So that is how to use the magic wand tool in Embrilliance StitchArtist to generate objects, which then, of course, you can add stitches to, just like I did like that, and create embroidery files.